আসসালামু আলাইকুম রহমতুল্লাহ, সম্মানিত ভাই বোনেরা, আপনারা সবাইকে আমি স্বাগত জানাচ্ছি আবার ইসহাক। আমরা টকিং অ্যাবাউট ইউথ লাইফ অ্যান্ড দ্য ইস্যুস দে ফেস, ইনশাল্লাহ নাও উইল বি টকিং অ্যাবাউট দ্য সলিউশনস ইজ ওয়েল। সো ক্যান আই জাস্ট গো স্ট্রেট টু মাসুম? মাসুম, উই এন্ডেড উইথ ইউ অ্যাকচুয়ালি। উই ওয়ার টকিং অ্যাবাউট সাম ইস্যুস, আই এম শিওর দে আর প্লেন্টি অফ ইস্যুস। ওয়াট আর দ্য ইস্যুস ইউ থিঙ্ক উই হ্যাভ টু টক অ্যাবাউট কোয়াইট ক্রিটিক্যাল?
টাইমিং অ্যাজ এ teenager, so obviously right now I'm 16 and I don't, because I'm in college, I don't really have enough time to go out and socialize with my friends because I might have to be concentrating with my A-levels. So obviously timing is a key issue, so yeah.
Really? Why do you think timing is an issue? You're not working, you're just studying, right?
No, but studying is hard because at the end of the day you don't want to waste 2 years of your life.
Okay.
You want to make them 2 years. You want to make them 2 years work.
Of course, no, that's fine. I mean, if some people are really hooked into, no, that's good. I don't know if that makes sense, but it's still okay. Any other one we missed?
I think job opportunities for young people, that's a big issue. I think a lot of kids are sitting at home doing nothing when they can use their time to either earn some money and, I don't know, return the favour to their parents.
But can they find a job though? It's difficult to find a job.
There's not enough opportunities out there for
kids. Okay, so who would you blame for that? Young people or the
other? I mean, it can be argued, but as a young child as well, you need to put your name out there as well, get yourself recognised.
Some people can be lazy, not doing anything and think about it, and also difficult to find. Did you find it difficult finding a job? Are you doing anything?
Yeah, it's very hard to look for jobs, as you apply for a lot, but you hardly get any feedback. They just give you...
Give me an example, like, so one evening you tried this place, that money CV has been gone, and you didn't get nothing. Give me an idea how you tried.
Oh, for example, applying for boots. I applied for boots. They called me for interview, online assessment, I passed everything. But at the end, they're like, I wasn't successful. So they basically give me false hopes. So like, it's not nice to like hear or get.
Do you know why they said no or anything? Do you think your CV wasn't good enough? Do you think the cover letter you wrote? Yeah, these are very important, isn't it? Your cover letter has to be good. Your CV has to be very practical.
I think my CV is top notch.
Okay. So they haven't seen you. I met a person actually who looks for jobs for young people. He says it's easy to apply for it. But it's very good to go on in your presence as well, so people know who you are.
Yeah.
And when you apply for the job, there are a lot of techniques actually. When you apply for a job, you can't apply for, you can use the same CV for it, you can't use it for everybody, same ones. So specifically if you say your boots, you have to say what boots about, what you know about boots, and blah, 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 who do you know inside. You help, so they know, this person has a lot of clue about this place, maybe he's the right person.
Yeah.
So these things help, so yeah. I'm glad you tried though. I've got two kids. They applied for jobs and blah, 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 blah. It's difficult for them, honestly. And they tried. Then you got dodgy ones.
Yeah.
They target young people. And you think you got a job, but actually no, there's something else, man. You work for them, they don't even pay you sometimes. That's what happens. So job is an issue.
Yeah.
What do we have to do? And what's the solution, you think? These are the problems we're facing. So how do we find a solution for young people? You guys are, mashallah, clean ones. There are a lot of young people, genuinely, like you said before, they've been trapped into drugs, they're trapped into gangs and stuff like that. So how do we save the innocent ones, or how do we save the people that are involved there? Hassanbhai, would you like to say a few things on that? Because you're a youth worker for a long time.
And I would say, obviously, I'm not like officially a youth worker, but obviously I do give my time voluntarily for the boys. Obviously I enjoy being in their company, spending time with them. If we achieve something, our whole purpose is, if we win, we win. But if we all come together and we win, that's an achievement, because we came together and then we won. That's an achievement. So something like that, that's the reason obviously why I enjoy that. I'd say...
How many people are you working with at the Boy FC?
In the squad, we got 39 people registered in the squad. And in training, it's roughly like 20 to 30, but they're not all players part of the team.
Okay.
There's people that come from the community that, they just want to keep fit. so they'll come and join in, but they're not, you know, in the team. But our door's open to everyone. So, for example, if you want to come and you just want to work on your fitness, you come and join in the training, everyone's made to feel welcome.
What's the age group?
So you have to be plus 16 plus to play for their team.
Okay.
But we welcome all ages to come and train with us. So we have even, we have kids young as like 14, 13, they come and train. You know, Muslim and these guys, they used to train with us before they were 16. And, you know, Muslim turned 16 this year. So alhamdulillah, he's joined the team and he's in the team playing now.
He looks fit, man. I don't know what that is. He's got a friend or something.
Yeah, he's a very speedy guy.
Okay.
The speedy guy's over there, actually. Okay. Abdul. Yeah.
Why? Are you a striker or something? Is he speedy or are you in the side?
A bench warmer.
Really? What's your position? What do you play?
Mainly on the right wing.
Right wing. Okay.
Just Martial.
It's because of his speed, isn't it? That's why.
Particular player do you follow?
Martial, because he stinks.
Ronaldo. Cristiano Ronaldo.
No, that's good, man. At least he's got someone to follow. That's great, man. So, a lot of people are in your working group. So, how do you go? It's a great way to get people engaged. People, if they're not doing anything, then they're going to end up in bad stuff.
Yeah.
So, how do we, what did you do to engage them in the first place?
Obviously, you see that, you know, you represent your community. You see that a few of your other friends are coming to play. You see, it's a good thing, you know. We try to do little get-togethers and things like that, you know, little rewards. Like we've got an award ceremony coming up next month.
Oh, mashallah, that's good.
That's just part of the team. We'll just be handing out some awards, you know, player of the season, top goal scorer, you know, young player of the year, you know, stuff like that. We're gonna give out little trophies, give a little food, invite the whole community, and yeah, that'll be a little evening for us. Previously, we've been paintballing and things like that. So, you know, there's good things we can do if you come along. The main part is obviously you have to want to be involved yourself as well. You know, some people, they don't want to be involved. You know, you can go to them, you can show them as much as you want, but they don't want it. You have to have that little bit inside you as well. But at the same time, you need people in the community to come forward. You know, we all rely on, it should be someone that gets paid to do this. You know, me personally, I just do it because I enjoy it. And, you know, when I was young, we didn't have that kind of thing around. We had youth clubs here and there. These days, there is no youth clubs.
There isn't.
I can't name one youth club in Bo.
It's difficult now, isn't it? Masum, you also play for the same team, right?
Yeah.
So, what's your role? What role do you play? Do you just play or do you help them to train? Tell me about it. How did you get involved in the first place?
Let me I got involved because at first I used to come training with Bo FC.
How old were you then, sir?
15.
Okay.
And then just to keep fit, and obviously I found it a good thing to do.
You're still 15, aren't you?
No, 16.
Okay.
And then, obviously, I've been playing football since young, so I just found it just a fun sport. But yeah, so I thought it would be right to just play for a team and obviously gain some experience.
Particular team you support?
I don't watch football like that. I just like playing football.
Okay. Interesting. Akib, tell me something about you. How you got involved? Are you one of the senior...
No, not really.
Okay.
I think I've always been playing football. I started under 12, and there was a football team called Ball Juniors as well. So I've always kind of been playing for the community. I don't know, when I turned 16, I started doing A levels, and I think I needed a break on my weekdays.
How was your A level? Tell me. That's interesting.
Obviously, A levels are stressful. But
it's hard, isn't it? It's difficult. That's the hardest exam, they say.
Yeah.
What did you have in your GCSEs?
It was. MashaAllah, good, alhamdulillah.
What did you have? You share with
couple of A-stars and A's.
So?
Couple of A-stars and A's.
MashaAllah, that's great.
MashaAllah.
That is great, yeah. How did you achieve that? Did you have... Were you hanging around with the... Like everybody else, or were you like isolating yourself, or you just studying and, you know, thinking about it? Like Masum said, no time, man. Studying is first.
I think I balanced my life out a bit because I'm at Madrasa as well. So I had Islamic side of thing covered, I had education covered, and I was playing football at the same time. So I was keeping myself fit and educating myself.
You know, you're a very lucky man. So that means you had a madrasa, you know, education, and then you have this.
Yeah.
Do you see any difference in him? Because he studied in madrasa, and now he's got, mashallah, doing very well in A levels and GCSEs and all that stuff. What difference do you see in him? Do you see any differences? No.
Differences of like
what? His morals, his speaking, his way of doing things. Do you see any differences, or do you feel he's just like everybody else?
No, it's a bit different from everyone else. because obviously I think he's the only one out of our age lot, like my friends, that went madrasa. So he has a bit of like knowledge in Islam and like general knowledge. So I think it's good to have a friend like that. It's good for everyone to be like that, but having a friend, having good friends around you will be good for you and for everyone else.
How did you get involved with football? And how did it help? I want to know, because look, we just want to try to get people out from the rubbish.
I started watching football. I didn't really play football when I was younger, but I started watching it. That's what inspired me playing, like start practicing, become better. Then I found out football team, area, the community, and then we joined, play, enjoy ourselves.
Do you want to become a professional? If you're good, why not? Why don't you try? Is there any opportunity to become a professional, you think?
I think everyone would like to be, whoever's a footballer, they would like to be professional. But I think for us, it's a bit restricted because not many Bengalis or Asians.
Okay, so I haven't gone to the top yet.
Yeah.
Well, we don't have any. There are a lot of teams.
There's not a lot of scouts that scout Bengali people, mainly other races or stuff.
Okay. What do you think we should do to break that down? I mean, it's not easy to suddenly create somebody. Listen, you're the top man, you take us to the Arsenal or Tottenham or Man United, whatever you are, scouts. So what do you think we should do? There are a lot of coaches are watching us. There are a lot of young people are watching us. They are involved in the football. So what do you think we should do about it? What do you feel like we should do to get our young people towards the top of football? Do you feel anything we could do? Do you have any
more
ideas?
More training, yeah. Practicing, become better. That's what we need.
Is there any way we can link with those, like our local East West Ham,
yeah,
our Tottenham, Arsenal? They are, you know, making a lot of money, man.
What I'd say is we can be better. It's just having the facilities, having the time, you know, having the people dedicated to doing it. With the parents, you know, if your son plays for academy football team, you get into academy, it's a big achievement, alhamdulillah. I know a lot of young boys, there's a brother called Imro, he coaches Sporting Bengal. Mm. They're doing a lot of good things in the community. He was running a team, 5 or 6 of their boys got scouted for QPR.
MashaAllah, that's good, man.
And MashaAllah, they're very good players. And he came and told, he was talking about it to me, and he said, you know, Bengali parents aren't always, they don't attend the trainings and the matches, whereas, you know, the non-Bengali parents, they will be at every single match.
They support them all the way.
Every single training, you know. That academy, they were saying to one of the boys, because his mum and dad wasn't coming to the training or matches, but obviously this brother Emro, he was taking him along. They said to him, you know, if his parents or someone doesn't show up, he's going to lose his spot in the academy. So the support from the parents is crucial.
Why do you think we are not into that position to take our kids? Is the kids don't want to take us with them, or do you think is that another case?
To be honest, you can't blame the parents all the time.
Because some of the kids say, oh, don't drop me at school.
Yeah.
Don't come with me, please. I'll go by myself.
Some of the parents, you can't blame in that situation, because, you know, you got parents that they work, you know, just to make, you know, give them ends meet to the children, the family. You know, hopefully young people, obviously, I'd say personally, I saw it too late, you know, that my parents were working hard for me. I'd say personally, I saw it too late. But, you know, if people, young people can see it from a young age, your parents, like, you know, they come, they give up their life in another country. They come here just for you, to so you can have a better life. They will work like 12 hours standing up straight in a row. You know, they do that for you. But then they don't have the time to go to the football and things like that. But whereas, you know, if we had the facilities, like I say, you know, local schools, I don't want to put names out there or put anyone in a bad position, but, you know, like Bobo School, they've refurbished, they've got a brand new building, indoor football pitch, outdoor football pitch on the roof. Semple's Way's got so much space for football, but where is the access for the local community? Why, you know, in my mind, I think that why can't there be one day where you say, here, the local community, you come and use the football pitch. And me, I would grab a lot of young people and I say, come on, boys, we're going to play football.
Even the green space are going. So you guys are playing football now. You won't be playing after a few years. The green space is going to go.
But you know the facilities they have. You can play football throughout the whole year, any weather condition. You know, it costs.
I think we should go and have a chat with them. I don't know if you've tried.
I've tried, but they want money.
Okay. Oh yeah, that's another thing. They want money.
At the same time, you know, there's been a lot of, you know, the people that run our team. You know, there's a lot of brothers like Rocky Ball, Yusuf, myself, Sazad, and Musa. They're like the core senior members of the team, and then you have myself and a few other senior players. But those brothers, they were giving out of their own pocket, you know, just to make sure we can play football. Then we got a bit of help from Triple BCO. They're doing a lot of good things as well in the community. They're our neighbour community. Yeah. They're doing a lot of good things, and we're trying to emulate what they're doing.
Fantastic. Masum, can I ask Masum something?
Yeah.
Masum, if your parents wants to take you to the training, would you be okay with that? And
personally, yeah, I'll be okay. Because me and my dad, we have like a close relationship, and like, you know, he's always supportive of what I do. So personally, for me, it would be fine.
Yeah. Wow. Is he your role model?
Yeah, I would say he's my role model, obviously, because he come to this country young. He obviously went through racism and stuff like that. And he obviously, he stuck through it. And now, obviously, he might not be the best like person in the world or the richest, but for me, he's like up there.
No, that's great. Honestly, that's great. You know, good to know about a youngster talking about their parents. You know, this is something we're lacking in people. All people think, oh, young people, not, you know, they're not respecting them. But we don't even speak to our young people to know, do you respect me or not? I mean, we're just staying, just assuming things. And the younger one probably thinks, oh, these guys don't know anything about anything. I think this is really a too extreme side of it. You know, we need to know, like, genuinely, do we care or not? Of course, I love our young people to do successfully, successful as well. But if I don't talk to you, you will never know how I feel. Do you look up to anyone? In football, I'm sure you always have a star. Like you said, Ronaldo, you like Ronaldo. Do you have any other person you inspires you and see as a role model?
I would say my dad as well.
Wow, awesome, man.
Because
why?
He's a very humble person. In my local area, he's very known. People look up to him. People go up to him for advice, help. He's there to provide that with them. And I want to be a person that's known in the area and
for good reasons, of course, yeah. So do you guys go out and eat together?
Yeah.
That's cool, man.
And not.
That's good. That's good. You want to add me anything?
Yeah.
Sounds like he agrees with that. Do you have any role model yourself?
I know. Me, myself, yeah. Of course, my dad as well, but something different will be, I think, the Prophet as well.
MashaAllah.
He's
role model to everybody, of course.
Yeah. That's a bit something different, but...
Specific reason why you choose Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Specific, because you're from Madrasa, so I'd love to know specific why.
He was the best human being ever.
What do you pick up from him the most? His kindness, his
everything
braveness.
About him.
What do you pick up first?
Of his like how spiritual he is, how gifted he was, and how he interacted with the community as well. Because he was a leader of the community as well, so a lot of people looked up to him and followed wherever he could and did what he did.
Do you find difficulties, like, you know, we see local papers are talking about Muslim extremists and this and that, so many negatives about Muslims.
Yeah.
There are some in it, but of course, we are not extremists. We are peace-loving people. So do you think it's a pressure for you guys, youngsters in the schools and or universities, naming yourself a Muslim or asking a place to pray? Do you have a difficulty in saying it?
Sometimes there can be a bit of discrimination, sometimes, but... end of the day, it's you praying, you trying to do your bit. So you can't really stop someone from praying. I think some people do look at your religion and like kind of cut you off from what you want to do. So if I was to apply for a job, for example, and I say I was Muslim and I was Bangladeshi, for example, they'll probably look at someone else with so like some same characteristics as them and like employ them instead of me.
Wow. You guys, all of you guys linked with football, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you like about football, man? Tell me.
Stress relief.
Something we enjoy playing. It's like something we look forward to at the end of the week, Friday, after all of the hard work in school, college, work.
Why do you think our parents are scared to let the kids go out, even in football or anywhere else? Why do you think it's the case? There are some genuine cases, like even my kids, to be honest with you.
There's injuries, you might be scared of your kids
getting
injured.
Overprotection.
And obviously no parent wants to see their kid get injured, but obviously it does happen. But at the end of the day, if they're willing to do it and whatnot, that is that it's a sport. Stuff happens.
Also, another thing is that who they're meeting. Who are those people who are going to go in touch with?
Mm.
Are they people, are they good? Are they right people? You know, a lot of things comes into our head because you guys are still young, you know. Honestly, first time when my, I'm always friendly with my kids. But I was doing a course, parenting courses, and in the course they said, take your boy out. And let him become a dad for today, and you become his follower. And I took him out. He's in his 19 actually at that time. I took him out, and we had a food together. And I said, today, whatever you say happens, you choose the place, the food, and I'll pay, don't worry. So we went out together, had a food together, and I asked him, do you think I'm a good father? Do you think I'm one of the someone you can look up to? Or do you think I should change? Be honest. I want to know, honest answer. I want to change. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. There's no handout, man. Because he's the best person. He's my son. I want to do the best for him. I want to be best for him as well. And he said to me, you're okay. You're right. I said, no, I want to be specific. He said, you're okay, but you know, like, you shout a lot. Okay, I'll change that. What else? And from that day, honestly, we become best friends. We become best of friends. He's 21 now. And if I ask him, oh, can I jump in your bed? Yeah, come. So we can have the same, we can watch the same movie together in his bed. Because we became good friends. So we need to break that down. If it's possible, it's brilliant way, because we have to live together, man. So we need to find a way. So I think football is one of the best way to engage people from away from those troubles, the gangs, the drugs, and what things we talked about. But how do we show our parents? The football players, mostly actually, they're not bad boys, actually. Isn't it? Mm. They're not bad boys. They don't have time for those things. And the ones that are bad are usually doing something else. Mm. They're busy there. So is that the case in your team? You don't mind sharing with us?
I'd say, mashallah, these three young boys, they're excellent examples of how young people should be. I mean, you know, if they're in a group of people, they might get stereotyped because of the people they're with. But, you know, even I used to think they're little troublemakers, but, you know.
Is it because of the style, or is it because of how they look?
It's just that, it's just that you hang around.
We have to be really careful, man. Style doesn't make people bad.
Style doesn't make people bad, I mean.
You have to be very careful.
You get judged, I could, on the weekend, I might dress in my tracksuit bottoms, I just feel comfortable that way. But someone might say,
you imagine Hassan Bey with his shorts on.
They see me with shorts every time in football.
Okay, that's cool.
So, but honestly, I mean, we've got a lot of good young people in the area, but you just want to give them more. You want to keep a hold of them because, through the football, if we're not doing well, we haven't got the facility to train, we haven't got the facility to play, we haven't got nice kits, why would that young person want to carry on playing football? He's going to be like, they wear some smelly kit, they don't have no money to wash their kit, we play football on a rubbish pitch. Why should I play football, man? I might as well go and do something else.
Yeah.
We need to give that, but it's just not football. With Bo FC, we want to use the football as the core foundation. Like with the guys, we're all going to help out with a new charity. It's called #LoveRohingya. Everyone check it out on Instagram. Bo FC is going to help with that. It will be a good thing for us to get involved in as a team. We're going to get involved
and
help.
Involved, yeah?
We're all going to get involved, yeah.
Cool. Are they involved now?
The project's going to be launching next month. It's a group of people. They're going to raise money for Rohingya. The Rohingya community in Burma. Yeah, so it's called #LoveRohingya. They're on Instagram. They're just raising awareness. I mean, all the other places in the world, what's going on. I'm sure if I asked one of my colleagues at work, do you know Rohingya? I'm sure they would say no. So, they're raising awareness. So, Bo FC, we're going to do our bit to help out as well.
Is there any other trainings you guys doing, just apart from football?
Well,
can I ask you something? Is there any bullying happening in the football team?
Well, bullying, I wouldn't say bullying. We don't have bullying. We have something called banter. Yeah? Banter is, say, I'll give you a bit of stick, so you've done a bad pass or a bad shot. or something. I think someone done something in the last match. I'm not going to mention it. but if you ask the guys who's the best person they have banter with in the team, I'm sure everyone's thinking of that one name. You ask the guys, and they'll tell you. Talk about the banter guy, man, in the team.
Is he good? Is he good?
Yeah, he's good. He's on the show now, actually.
Okay. what are you talking about?
We're talking about you.
What is he talking
about? You, yeah.
No, I'm not talking about you.
Muslim, come on.
I'm joking now.
Maybe.
There's other people.
Huh?
Is that a man?
Yeah, I think okay. It's that is the funniest one.
Okay. What happens, John? What happens if you do anything wrong? They come after you or something, or they try to, they nick your trousers, socks, or whatever. I don't know. What do they normally do if you don't do well? Do they punish you?
No, like, for example, imagine I'm in a football game, all of us are playing. We threw on goal, like, you literally can just, like, tap it and the ball will go in and you miss. But our players would, like, don't, like, shout at you, demotivate you, but they would just see that standing for, like, the funny side of it. So they would, like, start, like, keep saying it or keep mentioning it. Oh, you're rubbish, stuff like that, but they don't actually mean it.
But do you feel bad?
Nah.
You know it's for fun.
Yeah, you just take it on the chin.
What do you do on your bad days? Say you played today and you lost a game.
Yeah.
It could be one of the really, really crucial games for you.
Yeah.
So how do you pick yourself up? It's important. How do you pick yourself up?
Training
what do you
harder.
Do?
Training harder.
What else do you do?
Because I'm
you're very low in your confidence and everything else.
By watching football. Analyzing football.
When you choose your friend, what do you see in them? Can I ask you? Just
it's
a personal thing. Yeah, when you choose a friend, what do you see in them? What kind of quality do you see in them? Because a friend can be really, really crucial partner for crying.
You need friends that you can be successful with.
And they will be there when you're on your downfall.
Okay. I'm going to come after you in our break, because we have to have a little break. Shomani to Bible Nera, Afanaz Akhtesan. You can phone us, there's a number there, and also we were talking about issues like gangs, knives, smoking, drugs, so much stuff, and now we're talking about the solutions. If I can add to it, you'll be really, really happy to share your views with us, inshallah, and I'll see you after the break. Stay with us, don't go too far. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Oh.